So this is the first video, and this is going to be a series where I show every single zone in the game and how to get from A to B and where the objectives are and if people actually use the zones at all. So this is the first zone. This is where you pick up your weapon, and this is the guy you speak to, and then the zombie pops up and you get a gem. Okay, then you just keep running along the shore. You can look at the map. If you do it like this, that's fine. You can do it a bit more linearly, making it faster. For instance, I would probably just run straight over here, or something like that, and just do it like this. All you want to do is get to Hillock. The only thing I stop for, which is not really a stop, is if there is a chest like right on my path. Then I will click it while I run, so I open it. And I'm gonna look at the contents while I'm running. If it's something I really, really want, then I'm gonna loot it. If not, then I'm just gonna pass it up. So that's basically it for the first zone. Next up, we have the coast. The coast is a bit more confusing than the Trilight Strand, but it's not really a problem, usually. If you just follow a path that's pretty linear, you can pretty much just follow this zone wall here, if that's what you want to do. So if we try and do that, let's see what happens. So, most people actually skip every single monster here as well. I just ran past the blue pack. I might want to kill those, but not if it takes me too long. So, as you can see here, you meet a ledge right here. And if you run down here, on the other side, you want to get down to the lower point of this ledge. Then you're basically there. There can be two, like there is right here. And that's basically it. As soon as you see this waypoint, you're pretty much done. You take the waypoint, you don't have to take the waypoint, and then you just continue forward, and here's the zone, the next zone, the mud flats. So this is the mud flats, and this is where you will do your first actual quest to progress, because it's barricaded behind this quest. So you always start near the beach. You can always see the beach whenever you enter the zone. And you can just follow that, like we have done before, until you get to this water going into the land. Then you can follow that stream, and you will find the first nest right there. You will get a quest item whenever you click it. And people usually kill a few of the rowers here that are around, just because there's always a pack of rowers at the nest. Sometimes it's a blue pack, in that case you will definitely kill it. Otherwise, just leave it. You don't have to kill everything, just kill one or two. It's just to make it more safe so that they don't stun you every single time they hit you. And then you just follow the stream. You come to this place, there's another nest, and you can see three rowers. You don't have to kill them, but if you want to, do it. And then you have a choice. You should never go backwards. But if you go here, you can see you have two streams. This stream here is probably going to lead into a zone wall. So let's check that out. Oh, it's actually not. Is it? Ooh, it looks like it is. Yeah, it is. It's going to lead into this zone wall here. And into this boss mob here. Or rat mob, I guess. Unique mob. Which you don't have to kill. And you should really just leave it alone. But if we instead went down the correct path, which would have been the one leading away from the zone wall, because the water is down to the southeast, and the zone wall would then be on the opposite side, and I know there is one stream always leading into the zone wall, or one stream leading into another zone, so taking this path here should most likely lead to the other nest. And sure enough, this is the other nest. Whenever you have taken the three eggs from these nests, then you just keep going the opposite direction from where you came in, which was over here, down in the corner, and you just keep going, then this should pop up. And this is the next zone. So you go in here, you don't really have to kill anything in this zone in mudflats. I will suggest that you kill like rowers, especially if they're blue. And also any blue packs in general, I would probably kill. So you click this to unlock the submerged passage. So the submerged passage is a pretty big zone. It can be at least. You always enter into this little circle nowadays, and then there is a bridge. You have to go towards the bridge. You have a waypoint, take the waypoint. Then you have two options basically. You can either go this direction or you can go up this direction. And it's usually the same if, let's say, it was we came in up here, then you could probably go down and to the left. Stupid zombies. So if I go to the right right now and just follow the stone wall, I'm gonna come to a dead end right here. Yep. And if I go a little around here, I'm gonna come to another quest zone, which is, if I just keep following this, just keep following, keep following, gonna come to a hole in the ground, the flooded depths. This place is where you can get an extra skill point for killing a monster down there. I will show you that later, but it's a very linear zone. Instead, I suggest that you go diagonally from this entrance point towards this point over here. So if you just go up, you can also just go this way, as we just did. But if we go up here, oh, can you see this? This is a bridge, and you can see it's tilted a little bit. You always want to find this. So you want to find this, and as soon as you have found this, you know you're in the right, going in the right direction. Just keep going. You can basically not do anything wrong by this stage. Just have to go and then go up. Always go up though. If you can, like here, you can go up and down, then go up. Always go up. And right here is the entrance to the ledge. Yay. I will say that killing monsters in this zone might be something you really want to do, especially these small blue ones. These crab things here, it's a bit annoying because they actually have, like, when you kill one, then another one comes. That's kind of annoying, but these small blue ones, they're quite easy to kill and fun to kill, so kill a lot of those. And again, all blue packs, probably kill them. Leave all the unique monsters and all the rares, just leave them. Ledge, much like the Twilight Strand, I feel kind of stupid talking about it, but this is a super linear zone, you can't really do anything wrong here. So you can just keep going. The packs are quite good though. As you can see here, the pack size is pretty good. So usually what I would do is run past something like this, run over to get something like this, and then do some massive AoE attack and try and kill all of them with that. I wouldn't kill something like this. This is a waste of time. Just keep going if it's like 3 or 4 or 5. But something like this, kill it. Open chests along the way. Take the waypoint. I think if you for some reason have to log out, or if you just let's say you come to this point and you have to go eat or whatever and you have to log out or anything, when you come in again, when you take this waypoint, then which direction is the right direction? Let's make a new one. Let's do it like this. So now I have no idea which way is the right direction. The map doesn't show. Well, you can see these three rocks here. They always show the right direction. So if you just go in that direction, you should go to the next zone, the climb, and not backwards to the submerged passage. So yeah, besides that, then you have Kaduku, a unique monster that doesn't really do anything. Well, he casts some lightning, but apart from that, he's not a moving boss, so he's quite easy. You can just keep moving along the zone wall here, and you will find, whoops, you will find the climb. The climb is always after this guy, he's always at the end, which is, that guy was Kaduku. And we should be there soon. It's just a long road, it's a nice place if you want some experience. So, next zone is the climb.
Okay, some time has passed and we are at the climb now. This is a new leak, but basically everything from before still applies, so nothing really changed in that manner, other than my character. So, the climb is a very linear zone as well. And when you come to this point here, you can see on this, on the map here, I'm just gonna deal with these. You can see on the map here that you have these ledges all around, and you have them here, and you can see them. When you come to a point where you see, if you just see this, the top here, if you imagine you can't see further than where I'm standing on the map, then you can see these two here. There is an extremely good chance that the waypoint is there. I would say always. The only reason why I'm not saying 100% is because it can't be other places that have the same pattern, but the waypoint is always up on a hill like this, and it's always to the side. So that's basically it. If you want the waypoint, the waypoint doesn't really matter. You just keep going forward. The zone is very linear. As I said, it's filled with skeletons and these goldmen here. A lot of jumping goldmen. It's going to be kind of annoying. There is also a unique boss kind of towards the end. Or a unique mob, I should say. It's not really a boss in my world, since you don't have to deal with it. It's this guy here. This Forsaken Archer here. He does not do too much, I would say. He, as you can see, he uses split arrow and uses rain of arrows. That's basically it. But, I mean, when you are the appropriate level for this zone, let's say you're level 6 or 5, then he is going to do more damage, obviously, than me just standing here. The next thing that comes up is kind of a new thing, actually. So you can see all these goldmen right here, and so then somebody jumps down. This unique guy right here. This didn't used to be in the game. This is kind of new. This is where you get I don't want to call her a master, but this is where you get the lady that will let you do the prophecies. She's caged in here the first time if you haven't released her. You need to kill this mob here, and then you can click on it and release her. Yeah, that's basically it. When you have done that, if you want to do it, I suggest doing it. Then keep on moving, and you should be up at the lower prison very fast. The lower prison always starts like this. So you start in a little room, there's a door, you go in here, there's another door. They may or may not be locked, I actually don't know, but I think they're always locked. But the thing is, you can see on the map, you always go in this pattern right across to the waypoint that is right here. Okay, so now you're kind of in the middle. So if you imagine this being the middle, and then this being a big square, and down here you have a big square, this is two different, not different zones, but you want to find the exit to the next stage in the prison. You have to, it has to be either up here or down here, basically. And ever since they added the Trials of Ascendancy, the Trial of Ascendancy is always up here, which means that there's much more likelihood that the next stage for a prison is downwards. So I'm gonna try and go downwards here and see if we can find it. I wanna say that this is kind of my own thing. I don't really know if this actually have any meaningful meaning, but it seems to work pretty well, honestly. So that's basically why I'm saying it. If I didn't think it was actually a thing, I wouldn't say it. And here we go. So you can see we followed, we went down, and there is no other path in here than this. And we found the upper prison. Now, when I get to the upper prison, there is no Trial of Ascendancy in here. And I basically, it's 50-50. It's the same thing with a square up top and a square down at the bottom. I usually just go up. I mean, I like going up more than going down, so that's basically it. I don't think there is anything you can really lead from this. If anyone knows anything, I would love to hear it. You can run into a guy called Chatters along your way here. Also, Bonesaw is another mob, unique mob, that is around here somewhere. Chatters is a skeleton melee. It's kind of dangerous, actually, if you try to melee him, because he can slow you quite a lot. And does quite significant damage, and has some skeleton mages helping him out, or archers, I can't really remember that. And Chatters, oh, not Chatters, but Bonesaw is a necromancer, like this guy over here, keeps casting curses and raising all the skeletons. So yeah, you don't have to kill either of them. I actually suggest not. It's a waste of time in most people's opinion. Here is a Sawbones. Oh, Bonesaw. Sawbones. Well, close enough. He's dead now. And you can see the entrance over here, or the exit, however you want to see it. So that's basically it. I mean, this was the only way, as far as I can tell. You might be able to go down here and get up here faster. This place, it's 50-50, I would say, where it is. This is kind of unusual, in my opinion. Usually it's more off to, like, over here, or it's maybe up here or something like that. That's in the middle of the map, is kind of unusual. But yeah, that's it. After you get from the upper prison, you get to the upper prison. Let's go back and check that. It's the warden's quarters, and you're still in the upper prison. Yeah, it's kind of weird. But when you enter here, you get in here, you will always go this path. There is no other path. There are no mobs in here, with the exception of prophecies, spawning monsters. Ghosts can spawn in here, and also when you have the Pirandus mobs, the Pirandus boxes, the Pirandus leak, they can spawn in here. Well, they can't anymore, but they could. And now in Breach, you can have the Breaches spawn in here, so, but you have to activate them to actually find enemies. But this is basically always the same path, always. Then you get to here, then it forks. Most of the time it forks to either this direction or this direction, so you can go both ways. But as you will see right here, so now it forks, and either the Warden's Chambers is right here, or it's right on the other side, so not much lost there. This is the Warden's Chamber, and you can see we have Brutus here. Brutus is a big guy. He does insane melee damage, honestly, and he has a hook. He can hook you in. There we go. And he can impale you with these things. They're static, and he can ground slam. The ground slam is the most potent thing here. So be careful not getting hooked into a ground slam, or like you just saw there, being comboed down by something like that. That would be kind of nasty. When you do enough damage to him, he will also spawn cages falling down from the roof. You can't see them, but let's see if I can. Yeah, I killed him. I'm sorry. but he will spawn cages. They will fall down and crack open, and skeleton archers and normal skeletons will then chase after you as well. When you get him to around 50%, I would say. The only thing, really, when you kill him, all the other skeletons disappear, so you don't have to worry about them afterwards. Another thing would be, you can, so when you have killed him here, that's a checkpoint as soon as you kill him. So let's say you just want these glass and you want to keep on moving. Well, if you have to go up here, this is the only exit, then you have to go all this way here. The exit can be in either direction, and that's kind of a long way. That's not really how you want to do it. How you want to do it is, you want to exit the character selection and then just spam enter to enter again. You will spawn, well, you will not spawn here. You will spawn in the middle of this place right here. You will spawn right here, or close to at least. And then you can move down here to this waypoint. You can click on the prisoner's gate, and that will actually, you have this waypoint now. This is given to you. So you don't have to, you would also have, when you come out, you would have to walk from here and all the way down to the waypoint. And now you're here. It's much faster doing the logout thing compared to actually running all the way. Okay, that's basically it. Okay, so now you're at the prisoner's gate. You'll see this big road here. This road is leading forwards. That's kind of dumb. It's leading up ahead, and you can see on either side there is a stone wall over here, and there is one over here somewhere. Yeah, there we go. So this is kind of a canyon or something like that, and this road is leading all the way down. We can actually try and chase it. It shouldn't take that long. Then you will find that this place is barricaded. You'll find Piety, and she will say some things to you, and you'll have to find another way around for now. And the way you do that, if we go back here, is that you can see over here, there's nothing really on this side. All you have to spot is this little thing there, this little rock formation. Then you go down here. There is a path down this path right here, and there is sometimes one in the middle, but if you miss it, then there is also one at the top. Okay, go away, right here. So you can get down here as well. I suggest just going to one of the sides and just look for this, and if you go much further than here, then go to the other side. It's most likely on the other side. As you can see, this spawns pretty close to the waypoint here. So what you do is you go down to the middle, or you ideally you just go like this, and you're here. You need to find this path, and you just keep going. There's a lot of mobs here. It's actually a pretty good experience. There is also a unique hellhound that has a burning aura. He's at the end of the zone. He is quite annoying, actually, especially if you don't, if you can't sustain the burn, and you can't move fast enough. Here he is, the burning menace. Then he's going to be a problem for you. Try just leave him, run from him. You want to find, so one thing to keep in mind here is when you get into this, you're going to find these little nooks where you can kind of get lost in, because you have to find the next little path. We found it already, but when you get in here, let's say we get in here right now, then you can go left, right. So it's a gamble, basically. I usually, again, I like to go up because it's just, it feels better to move upwards because you can see more of the screen compared to down to your bar here. So I would usually go up in, at the beginning. You just follow the path and you should end up right here. So there are a few things you can do here. I'm just gonna, I locked that, that's why. Oops. So here's the other one. He is a big goat guy. He's gonna spawn that totem with the Vile Fireball. He has a Fireball. I don't really, it's kind of weird. I don't think anyone else has that ability. And he's gonna spawn a lot of lightning and pretty much just be really annoying and tanky and move away from you. Try just to move past him. That's what I would do. But basically, what I wanted to say here, as soon as you see this right here, you can go ahead and if you have Flame Dash, which you get at level 10, and you're probably level 10 after you have killed Brutus, and you can get that as a reward in the city, then you can just Flame Dash down here. I'll show you why. Then you don't have to go all the way around here and all the way around here. So then you can just shortcut down there, because the exit is always up here. There we go. So instead of going all the way down there, you can just boop and then run this way. And then you are in the ship graveyard. Okay, next up, the ship graveyard. You always enter and you have this little path here and you can go left and right. Sometimes you have the beach right in front of you, and you can see the beach is out here now. But you basically just want to follow the beach. Just want to follow it all the way. When you see this, this is where you can have a quest, basically for a skill. You can do it whenever you want to. I'm gonna show that zone later, because it's not essential to actually going through the game. But you can just go past it, and keep going up, follow the shore. If you follow the shore, like we have done numerous times, then you will get up here to the Cavern of Wrath. So this is the Cavern of Wrath, and you have a waypoint up here. You have the bridge right here, which doesn't really lead anywhere. You can go read this if you want to, it doesn't really matter. It's just some lore. I suggest that you take this path that's always here as well, since this is just a longer way, really. And then you just follow the path pretty much until you find something where you have to make a decision. The decision being left or right. So I would just keep following this. This is one of Merivale's daughters. One weird thing is that even if you kill them, they still appear in the fight against Merivale. I don't know how that works. Maybe I should read some lore. But just keep following one zone wall. That's always a good tactic. And I would say one thing is what I'm basically always trying when I'm trying to find a new zone in this game, or the next zone, is if the entrance is here and it kind of leads out in a cone like this, then the exit is probably over here. It's probably the furthest away you can go. So let's test that theory. So we keep going. Let's go down a bit. There's one of the breaches. And I mean, when it keeps going on and on and on, and you can keep going the same road, that makes me kind of happy, because I'm pretty sure then that we are in the right location. When you see these bridges right here at the end, because this is the end, then you know you're in the right place. This is the Cavern of Anger. Yeah, that's basically it. Try to see if you can find a road that keeps going on and on and on, and it doesn't feel like you are changing direction. That's probably your best bet. When you enter the Cavern of Anger, you will see this most likely, and you can go this way, which is again like in the previous. It's pretty much the same as before. You're just gonna take a longer road, so just go up. You'll meet some mobs most likely, and then you're gonna run into this situation a lot of the times, and you're also gonna do that in the previous cavern of Wrath. And the problem is, you can see there are a lot of different ways here. So what do you want to do? You can either go up this way or this way. I'm still gonna stick with my solution, in quotation marks here. That was Merivale's other sister, but my solution being that it's probably the furthest way that I can go. When that is said, I will say it's up in this corner or in this corner. It's not down here. So let's go. I will go the furthest way I can, so diagonal in the beginning, and when I see something like this, I'm just gonna go the other direction, because then it's not that way. This is probably a dead end. If it's not, then it's probably the right direction. This is promising, gotta say. Very promising. Oh, and I ran into a wall. Not much backtracking, but this is how it often is in this situation. Again, a wall. So my two guesses of it being up in this corner and this corner was wrong, but I'm still on the right track, I would say, because it's right over somewhere around here. You can see it gets larger and larger, and you don't really run into too many dead ends anymore. So as soon as you see these ghosts that disappear, you know you're in the right direction. Then you just keep going. And you see these gold piles, and when you see the bridges, you're there. Basically, you just have to go over the three bridges here, and you are at Merbel's lair.